So now what I'm going to do is talk about how we expand that on a per flow basis. So the way the Meru system works at a high level is the following. You have access point that communicate with an end device. You have a controller. And then you have communication with a backend server. So it's important to know that unless you specify for an SSID or an ESS profile, really, whether packets are either going to be tunneled or bridged, by default, packets will be tunneled back to the controller. You also have the ability to, in fact, say for certain SSIDs that packets will be bridged back from the AP. That's going to be discussed in a companion video. So right now, I want to focus on the default mode, wherein all packets are tunneled back to the controller. So let's assume this user, U, is communicating with a server S. The packets go over the wireless. They get tunneled from the access point into the controller. This is where we apply the QoS and firewall rules. And then on that basis, the packets go on an appropriate VLAN that is mapped for that ESS profile. So the question is, what is the treatment for these packets that is applied here? And that's where we get into these rules. Okay? There are three parts to how we do the treatment of packets here. The first one is classification. So once we classify the packet, we do what we call a flow mapping. And then we do action. We classify packets on the basis of the following: the source IP, the destination IP, the source port, destination port, and the filter ID that I talked about. Okay. So when a packet comes in, based on any combination of these five parameters, source IP, destination IP, source port, destination port, and filter ID, which is, as we talked before, user-based, location-based, and SSID-based, the packet gets a particular classification tag. On the basis of this classification tag, we can choose to either drop or capture or forward the packet. By drop, I mean, obviously, that packets are not forwarded. By forward, I mean that the packets are going to be forwarded, subject to some additional treatment that I'm going to talk about. And by capture, I mean that there might be some local application services. For example, if you want to do some SIP processing for voice, additional voice processing, you have the ability on the basis of this five tuple to take packets and actually put them up. Okay? Wherein the packets are not forwarded, they aren't dropped, but they're locally captured, and then treatments can be applied to those packets. And we can talk in terms of specifically what sort of treatment we apply. Okay. In addition to this, you could actually take multiple flows, map them to a single aggregate flow. So you can treat each of these sessions, a five-tuple session, as an independent flow, or you could aggregate a bunch of these and treat them as a combined flow. So again, classification based on these different types, at that point, we can define the actions, but before that, we will do a mapping in order to either aggregate or pass as an independent session. What are the actions? The actions are either drop or capture or forward. In addition, when we forward, we have a couple of different options. You can just forward the packet as is. You can forward the packet by changing the diffserv tags. So for example, you can change the quality of service tags on the either the uplink or the downlink for the packet. And you can also do rate limiting. So by rate limiting, what we mean is that the total traffic transmitted for this particular flow, either an individual session or an aggregate of these, is going to be bounded by a token bucket that is specified as a part of the quality of service and firewall rule. Now let's look at some of the application cases. So in the previous example, where I'd drawn these different ESS profiles mapping to the same SSID, we could come up with the following construct. We could say all guest users in aggregate will not use more than 1 megabit per second. In a campus, all computer science students in the computer science building will get high priority. But in the student dorms, everybody gets the same priority. So the way we would use that is, for the guests, we would aggregate all the guest flows into a single flow, into a single aggregate, and then we would rate limit it as a part of the action to 1 megabit per second. For computer science students, we would specify two ESS profiles, both advertising the same SSID. The first ESS profile would apply only in the computer science building, and there, the action, once we forward the packets, we would tag the packet with higher quality of service. While in the dorm, everybody would go untagged. In other words, all packets would pass as is. So the point of this discussion is to talk about how, in a single framework, we are able to capture both quality of service parameters as well as firewall parameters, and we are able to do this on the basis of user, location, subnet, SSID, and applications. Thank you.